One is not going all the way, and the other is not starting. Now, clearly, Richard Gage and the movement that he's set forth has been off the starting blocks with the fury. And there's no question in my mind and in my heart that he will go all the way. And I believe that's why we're here. We want to go all the way, and that's why we need your support. And I think there was a gentleman who had a question, and if you'd like to ask that question, do you mind coming up?
Go ahead and take the mic to him.
Okay.
Last three questions.
First of all, Richard, I'd just like to thank you for doing what you do. I used to live in New York City, and my family's still there in Connecticut. And, well, it's just nice that people like you have made it their cause in life to at least try to expose what's going on. And I was just wondering if you have any thoughts about the 2012 National Defense Authorization Act. The lawsuits have been happening the past few days. Noam Chomsky, Naomi Klein, and the government lawyer basically saying, yes, if somebody writes a book with statements in it that we interpret as being supportive of associated forces of terrorism, we can detain them indefinitely without charge, military detention. Do you have any thoughts about that or how that might affect the movement? I know that the sovereign citizen movement across the states has been, it has been implied by the Department of Homeland Security that they are a nascent terrorist organization that's about 100,000 people, a lot of them support Ron Paul. And any thoughts you might have on that?
Yeah, that was a mouthful. Well, first of all, the National Defense Authorization Act is an executive order signed by, no, it's not, it's a legislative act, signed by President Obama, reluctantly, said, I'll never use this. This is a bad idea, but I'm signing it anyway, because he was told to, presumably. What it does is allow any of us in the United States to be put in jail simply by being called a terrorist. How do they define terrorists? They really don't. And that's a problem in and of itself. Put in jail indefinitely, without the right to a trial, without the right to an attorney, and not being charged, not being told what we're charged with. This is not the same America that I've grown up in. Something seriously has changed, not only with this, but the Military Commissions Act and the Patriot Act have removed many of our rights, have allowed the military to come in and police U.S. citizens, which is specifically forbidden in our Constitution, which is being shredded by these things, which is why we need somebody like Ron Paul to step forward, and expose what you referred to as tyranny. And I have come to agree with that assessment. There are some serious problems, and it's getting worse and worse, not better. Is there another question? And this is our second to the last question. Who's got the last question?
Can I have the last one? I guess.
Yes. Okay.
Thank you very, very much for coming down from Halifax here. I wouldn't say this is the last place we expected to see you, but we are very skeptical. So I think it's a great pleasure, and I'm disappointed that this place is not jam-packed tonight.
Yeah.
However, we are all messengers of the truth, and we'll check it out. And the least thing we can do is to point people to your video, your videos, so that they see what you preach, and also maybe to encourage people to buy the CDs. Now, my question is, I was skeptical from the beginning that in the halls of Afghanistan, nobody, not even you, let alone Osama bin Laden, could organize this from there. So now, the thing...
Afghanistan was invaded. If it wasn't for Osama bin Laden, what ulterior motive might they have had? Some people look at the pipeline that was being built to Afghanistan, which was being subletted to a Brazilian company instead of Unicap, which Hamid Karzai was an executive of, by the way. And so there's tremendous incentives for some to be in control of Afghanistan. There's the Taliban had some researchers have suggested that heroin and opium production is involved. Those who have looked at that have simply noted that the opium production had been shut off by the Taliban. Presumably, it's against Muslim law to engage in these kinds of things. Well, immediately after the Taliban was kicked out of power, the opium production skyrocketed. The profits from that production are four times the profits of all the oil companies put together. So who's in control of that? Well, you can do some research. It's very, very interesting. What happened in Iraq when we invaded Iraq? Was it for weapons of mass destruction? Was it for ties for Osama bin Laden? Or was it for, as most people think these days, about oil? Let's go. You say benefit. There's great opportunities for research there. And the final question over here.
Okay, can you bring that mic over? Who's got the mic?
Forgot to put the batteries in.
That was scary. I saw a lot.
Daniel,
you ready?
Go ahead.
I'll do this one. Just a second. Okay,
you up?
Are you aware that there might be very many people in the audience that will remember this, but I'm going to ask a question. You probably don't know the answer, but are you aware that on the day of 9/11 and the next day that the local media in Halifax? Okay, you're ready now. This is going to be a real shocker, I'm going to tell you. All media was doing this. Okay, every network, every radio station reported the same story for almost a day and a half, that the car that the terrorists had was found at the Halifax airport. And the other story they were telling us is that the terrorists were seen in Yarmouth waiting to board the ferry, and they were partying at the tavern. That's right. They reported this to all of us, okay? I'll tell you something. You don't know who I am. I'm a guy who was running a business, was asked to go to these guys' homes to empty their homes out. I know the story. It almost cost me my life. I told the FBI what I found out, what was going on. And after I went public to the FBI, the whole story disappeared off the internet, off everything. Every media made it disappear. So what I'm telling you is that the story about 9/11 is a little bit bigger than the world is being told, because they tried to implicate Canada, because they had already written all the anti-terrorist laws, just like they did with the Patriot Act. It was written in advance. They tried to involve us. And I'm the guy that said no. And I'm the one that went public. Because I was already an activist on the internet and well-known, they were scared to death of me telling my story. Anyway, they destroyed my home, my life, everything. And I ended up in a wheelchair because they ran a car over me. Okay, they really tried to kill me because I've been telling the truth. You know, I love what you're doing, and I can tell you this, take it from me. I've given up a lot of my life to be an honest human being, but nothing in the world is going to stop me from caring for love, and not the love of truth. Sorry, I didn't say it right. What happened in New York City, for me, out of all the things I've ever studied in my life, is absolutely the most horrific thing I can ever imagine. You can't imagine what has happened there. We weren't there. We weren't there, none of us. You're traveling all around. You're an American, which touches you more because you're an American. But believe me, the world is full of good, loving human beings. We all care about what happened in New York City. And I'm glad you came over here, because until I die, I am never going to stop telling and researching and doing what I can to contribute, just like you are. And there's a lot of us doing that now. Don't get discouraged, because the world has more good people in it than anything else, and we are winning the battle. What you're doing here is a piece of the puzzle. And there's Pilots for 9/11 Truth, there's Lawyers for 9/11 Truth, there's Police for 9/11, there's a whole bunch of organizations, and I cannot wait till the day comes when you all get together and we have a real public inquiry investigation and everything comes out, because all these intelligent people have done the work like you. and you put all the pieces together, my opinion, it's not an opinion, it's a fact. I know for a fact. It was no guy sitting in a cave in Afghanistan with a laptop when Afghanistan didn't even have the internet back in 2000, okay? 2001, there was no internet over there. So please keep up the work, right? I love you, you're a great man. Awesome. And thank you for coming over to Halifax.
Awesome.
All right.
Thanks everybody, enjoy us. And we're gonna be at the place that he mentioned.
The Hotel Atlantica. We'll be in the lounge, you'll see us. And again, remember, if you'd like, sign up on our sheet to participate and be a part of our group.